Podcasting number one, recording. In this video, you'll learn how to attach the microphone and headphones, how to turn the recorder and microphone on, how to do a sound check, and finally, how to begin recording your podcast. You'll be using an iRiver MP3 player to record your sound file. These players are no longer made, but they make excellent low-noise recordings. The headphones have ear pads that are wide enough to cover your ears and block out some of the surrounding noise. Remember that they do have a volume control on the headphone cable, so if you plug them in and you can't hear any sound, check to see if the little wheel on the volume control is rotated all the way to the right. We use Sony microphones for our recordings. These are excellent microphones, but you must use a strong voice when recording. If your recording is too quiet, you'll have to do it over. Now it's time to begin hooking up the cables. Take the microphone cable and insert the plug into the side of the iRiver where it says Line In. Take the headphone cable and insert it into the jack on the left end of the iRiver. To start the iRiver, hold down the stereo button for 2 seconds. When the iRiver is started, it should display this screen. Notice that the Ready Record screen should say Stereo. If it does not say Stereo, give the iRiver to Mr. Clausette and have him adjust the settings. The microphone will not work unless this screen says Stereo. With the microphone held securely in the grip holder, slide the microphone switch to the middle position of 90 degrees. A small LED just above the power label will flash red when you turn the mic on. The LED will not stay on, however. It only flashes to let you know there's enough power in the battery. With the microphone and headphone cables attached to the iRiver and the iRiver and mic turned on, now it's time to do a sound check to see if everything is working properly. Put the headphones on, make sure all the cables are hooked up correctly and the iRiver and mic turned on. Now scratch the foam cover on the microphone and see if you can hear the sound. If you can't hear the sound, then check the microphone cable first to see if you need to adjust the volume. If there's no sound, do not begin recording. You may want to ask Mr. Clausette for help in troubleshooting this problem. By using the proper techniques, you will have better luck at making a recording that is good the first time. Hold the microphone 1 inch from your mouth and rotate the mic 45 degrees off center. Speak clearly and modulate your voice. Remember, slow down. Speak calmly. Speak slowly. Pause at the end of your sentences. Hold the mic 1 inch from your mouth at a 45-degree angle. Press the mode button to begin your recording. The iRiver will begin timing your recording. The time numbers will change as you record. Everyone makes mistakes. Pauses are no problem since they can be deleted easily. However, if you make a mistake, stop, put your paper down, clap your hands close to the mic. Pick your paper up and repeat the sentence. If you make more than 3 mistakes, though, you'll have to start over. It's just too hard to do an editing job when you have lots of claps and lots of mistakes. Write down the file number of your recording. Remember that EXMIC stands for external mic. The 3 numbers after the letters complete your file name. To end the recording, press the mode button, the one with the red dot. If the very next thing you want to do is listen to your recording, press the stereo button. The iRiver will play back your recording and you can listen to it through the headphones.